The Rovers Chat YouTube channel is proudly sponsored by SixYardsOut.com. They've got retro football from every era with mugs, phone cases and much more. They also have plenty of Rovers goods, including apparel with the famous 94-95 season and this season's kit. Check them out using the link in the description below.
Hello Rovers fans and welcome to another matchday experience as it's four games to go, and if you're talking about last chance saloon and Rovers hanging on by a thread, boy, this is it, isn't it? Big game for Rovers today at home to Stoke City. Easter Monday, nice to get on the road on an Easter Monday game. But yeah, Rovers need nothing more than a win today, else really that is curtains. And I know that some people think it's already over, got to admit. I'm probably one within that territory as well. Yes, I know we're only 2 points off the playoffs, but I think we're asking ourselves to do an awful lot. You know, winning away at Preston, winning at home to Bournemouth, and some results to go in our favour as well. Just feels like it's a little bit too much for us to do. But, you know, we will carry on. We'll keep supporting. We'll do the very best that we can. And if you're not subscribed to the channel, please hit that subscribe button and please give this video a like for us. Yeah, my thoughts on the game before I go up. I'm just begging for a positive formation. You know, Peterborough, I know that Teo Edun is getting a lot of pelters for what he did and, you know, the two yellows and things like that. And yes, I know that Tony Mowbray can't do much about that. But I think my criticism is, once again, it's a back five formation against a side that concede a lot of goals and haven't won many games and are being relegated down into League One. I just want a positive formation. I want to see Bradley Dack from the start. I want to see Tyrese Dolan in this side. I want to see a little formation change where we're really going to show that we want to win the game. You know, that's what we want as fans. Let's get the job done, then make the subs. You know, bring on your Bradley Johnsons, your John Buckleys and others to see the game out at the end. Even Daniel Ayala if you want to, you know, and just see the game out rather than the other way around that we've got at the moment where we're relying on that defensive solidity, not creating many chances. And obviously we're coming the wrong side of those fine margins at the moment. So, yeah, I just want to see a different approach for these final four games. You know, we'd love it as fans, wouldn't we, if we just came out all guns blazing and went for it. You know, I want to see a 4-2-3-1 formation. I want to see Gallagher as a central striker with players buzzing in and around him and actually an interchangeability there as well, where all four of those attacking players, they can go wide, they can go central, they can drop off. I think that's where we've looked dangerous this season. But let's see what Tony Mowbray does. We're probably going to see the back five, aren't we? You know, it's tried and tested for him, but it's all about the result today. Obviously, just about to get on the road now. Middlesbrough have got Huddersfield. You know, it looks like Luton, Huddersfield and Nottingham Forest are away from us now. So, really, looks like it's between us, Middlesbrough, Sheffield United, possibly Coventry and Millwall as well. So, you know, lots of teams going for that final spot. And it's a shame it's come down to this because we should be well out of sight if you think about the drop points. You know, I've spoken before about Swansea away, Reading away, Hull away, Bristol City at home to get 0 points from those. The drop points away at Coventry, home to Luton. There's a number of points where you can just point to the fact that we should be comfortably sat within this top six. But it's not to be. We go to the final four games now, just hoping, praying. Let's hope we can have some Easter Monday cheer. Then let's see what we can do away at Preston. But yeah, you know, we're very much in the hope rather than expectation. As you can see, sweating a little bit. It's a bit hot in this car, so I best get on the road so I can get this bloody aircon on. But yeah, nice day. It's been a nice weekend. Looking forward to seeing Luke. Catch you in a bit. Come on, you Blues.
Walk into the ground with me, dreamy sidekick, and Luke Kimberley. Yeah, how you doing, mate?
I'm all right. I can just for a look at this outfit. This is unbelievable. I've ended up like
just
this.
Go in front. How does the saying go?
Rovers at three, Rob at six, I think, this outfit, isn't it? It's ridiculous. I don't know how I've ended up like this. I really don't. It's comfortable. It's comfortable. I'm comfortable with it. I'm an athlete, you see.
You had a good Easter weekend, though, so far?
I have, yeah. It's been all right, yeah. Doing a bit of running now, like I said. I'm an athlete.
Oh, you are
an athlete. I'm a seasoned man, so yeah, it's been nice. Weather's been great, hasn't it? A couple of barbecues here and there. Feet up. Just enjoy it, I think, is what we need to do because the football was a bit of a down point, a bit of a sickener on Friday, but you've got to look at the results. Well, the result today with Huddersfield. I've kept saying it and I will keep saying it. While there's something to play for, there's something to play for. It's as simple as that. And while we're dropping points, so the teams around us are dropping points, and it's very much in our own hands still. So from my point of view, it's it's much better position to be in to go and have four, maybe seven cup finals to play for at this point. Rather than maybe being in a position like a Bournemouth, for example, that could potentially drop out of that top two and maybe go into the playoffs with no momentum whatsoever. So it's not ideal to be in the position that we're in and fighting for it. But we've got a chance. We go and win these games, and perhaps we do go into Birmingham with a real fighting chance then of making something of this season and having some playoffs to play for at the end of it. So, yeah, let's go into this game, Stoke City now today, and let's take this opportunity now, finally. It's a do or die away a few times now.
It's completely do or die.
So, yeah, it really is now.
Completely. You're probably more optimistic than me. I think, personally, we're leaving ourselves too much to do, but bloody hell, what a season this season is. To win today and go into the top six, psychologically, is brilliant for this squad, I think. Yeah. To put the pressure on Sheffield United going away to Bristol City at 5:30 as well, so psychologically,
yeah, massive game. It's not being funny. You go into a game against Preston, huge rivals. I mean, there's enough riding on that game as it is to go to the Deepdale. When was the last time we went to the Deepdale with something massive to play for? That was 2001, and then Jansen went and did the job. So, for me, win today, go into that derby, what an incentive for them boys then to go and really make something of this season now. It's do or die.
So I'm a bit 50-50 on the team news. It has landed. I'm 50-50 because it's five at the back, and I'm wanting the handbrake off this side, and I think four at the back with our attacking players in attacking positions is just better for this side.
I agree.
But it is Tyrese Dolan as the false nine, and Dolan, Diaz and Gallagher for me looks like a really fluid and flexible front three. Yeah. So that's why I'm a bit 50-50. What's your thoughts?
I agree completely. Crying out for four at back. I've said it before and I'll say it again. Bradley Dach should start games. I'm not buying into this. He's an impact player. He's a footballer. He's a footballer that loves playing football and he'll want to start games. He'll want to impact games from the off. He's fit enough to start. He's fit enough to influence games from the off. But he's not. Not in the squad, so it's no good talking about it. Spilt milk. The team is what it is. It is five at the back, and we've got to look at that front three and really hope that they can influence it. And like you said, Tyrese Dolan is a false nine. We've seen him in that position before this season. That's when he's been effective. That's when he's really had an impact on the game and really looked dangerous. So let's hope that that's going to be the case today. Interesting one with the. Obviously the defence of Stoke, we know what they're all about, we know they're good in the air and how easy it is for them to deal with, you know, those sort of balls, that sort of play. So it looks like we're going to be playing it into Tyrese Dolan and feeding off and very much trying to play a more creative and fluid attacking game rather than just lumping balls at it and hoping for the best. So it could be really effective there today.
So the only other moment of controversy today, I messaged you earlier and said, is this shorts weather? You can see on this video, there's plenty of blue sky, there's plenty of sunshine. You bottled it and said you didn't want to be held responsible for saying whether I wear shorts.
And that's
shorts
why I'm dressed like a complete and utter moron. It really is. This is what I had in the car, and this is how I've ended up, really. I had a big coat, and the big coat wasn't appropriate in the end. So instead, I look like I'm a...
Well, it's the day's first talking point. Have we dressed inappropriately? I know the sun's going to be shining on that Blackburn end for parts of that game. So if I get too hot, I hold you responsible today.
Well, you've gone for jeans. I mean, like I say, this is a very fluid outfit, as terrible as it is. I mean, like I said, I don't look great. I do look like a criminal. But you can roll the sleeves up, right? Let's have a look at Good Morning Britain. Yeah, what is it this morning?
Yeah.
LK today. It actually is LK today.
Lorraine.
Yeah. Lorraine. Kimberly today. I can roll the sleeves up. I mean, I've got Under Armour sort of training jogging bottoms on. So they can come up as well. So I'm very much, you know, long, short. It's as fluid. It's like the front three.
Oh, on that note, come on, you Blues. Bacon in the Blackburn. I ain't got shorts on because of you, but Ricky T's here.
How's the hot dog?
That's all right, yeah.
Look at them shades as well. You look absolute gangster. Absolute gangster.
So if we get a win, mate, in the top six,
yeah,
gonna get it today. You feeling it?
Not really, no.
Sorry to be pessimistic,
right,
but now.
That's enough for Rick.
Luke,
win. Are you feeling it?
Oh, what a bell that Rick is. Never liked him.
And Adrian, there he is, Adrian. Are you feeling a win in the top 10?
Oh, I hope so.
No one's confident. No one is saying yes. Come on, we're going to do it, surely. Come on, Rick. Second chance.
I was hoping before the team news came out, and then I was a bit disappointed. So,
yeah.
Does anyone need to put a show on for us? And then he put Johnson and Travis in midfield. Sadly.
Yeah, five at the back is a bit annoying. But me and Luke were just chatting about this on the way down. It's Dolan instead of Buckley. Yeah. So it's a bit more positive in that regard. And actually a bit of experience with Johnson in the middle. So,
yeah.
You know, he's been crying for us. So come on, we can do it.
We can get Broughton Diaz's birthday goal.
Yeah. Go on, you blue.
They've got the final countdown! The final countdown!
Oh, I'm taking pictures of you.
The final countdown!
This is it. It is the final countdown.
It's always better when they play the final countdown, I think.
Yeah.
Gotta say as well, I'm just gonna pan forward. Look at that, making sunshine. Are set, come on, you blues! Half time at Ewood Park here. Not much of a matchday experience so far. Pretty dreadful first half from Rovers, probably the worst that we've seen in the first half. I think we've had one shot, which was a Yamal Hecker header that went miles over the bar. The formation's all wrong. Joe Allen has got the freedom of Ewood Park. You know, Tyrese Dolan goes to press Allen, they just pop it back to a defender. He presses the defender, they just pop it to Joe Allen. And Joe Allen just taking up all the spaces in that midfield area. And we are severely lacking in quality, lacking in fight, lacking in desire. Fully deserve to be a goal down. And Stoke Group haven't really had to do much. I think they've only had one shot and score from it, but they are really just in second gear. So Rovers need a change of formation. Let's get the defender off. We've actually got two on a bucket. I take Jan Paul off. He seems to have just lost his head a little bit. Get Bradley Johnson off as well. Rothwell and Dak on. Change of formation. Four at the back. Get the fullbacks going forward. But yeah, it's now or never for Rovers. And it'll be a great way to do it, wouldn't it? Coming from behind, maybe a stoppage time winner. But this is anything but enjoyable at the moment. Not really recording much in the first half because I've just been sat there in pure disbelief just watching Joe Allen, as I say, just have the freedom of Ewood Park and just watch Rovers just puff and puff and not do much. Misplaced passes, stuff just being knocked hopefully into channels. Very few moments of quality or anything to inspire the fans that in the first half there. So yeah, I'll keep this first half analysis just short and sweet really, because we just need much more really flat here. This ain't a crowd who are cheering on the side going for top six at the moment. It's just a severe lack of quality, so I'm not even going to ask the other lads what they think, because it's just way too depressive at half time. But yeah, for me, formation change, get an extra body in midfield, stop those balls into Joe Allen, just hope for a big improvement. But yeah, our season is dying a death at this very moment, and what an opportunity we were given with Middlesbrough losing to go back into the top six. Stoke hit us with the early goal, and yeah, we just look not lightly at all. So big 45 minutes now, it can only get better. Come on, you blue. Just wait and see what happens with Bradley Dak here, because he was warming up at half time with Joe Rothwell and he seems to be holding his lower back area, so I hope that he somehow does get some treatment on it, but we might not see Bradley Dak for this second half, so we'll see as the players come out. But yeah, the biggest cheer at half time, one for Renzo singing happy birthday to Ben Brereton, and then another for some football freestyler who was doing some insane skills, to be fair, and then he balanced it on his neck and head and volleyed it into the Blackburn end. That's as good as it's got so far. Only get better. So I think we are going to see the formation change. Jan-Paul van Hecker looks to be the man brought off. He did seem to lose his head a little bit in that second half, was very lucky not to get a second yellow card, so Mowbray's responded to that. Joe Rothwell, the man just about to come on. So it looks like a formation change for Rovers. No sign of Bradley Dak, so I really hope he's not injured. That could be a blow for us, you know, the talisman that is Bradley Dak. But yeah, Joe Rothwell definitely coming on for Jan-Paul van Hecker, and we'll see what this formation changes. Come on, you blues.
Oof, what a game that was. Yeah, recording this a little later than I usually do after games. Just, you know, needed a few hours probably just to process that game. And yeah, we're still clinging on to that hope, aren't we? Sheffield United not getting the win away at Bristol City, but maintain the view that it's still too much for Rovers. We are now relying on others' results. You know, we need Middlesbrough, Sheffield United and Millwall, who have snuck in there now, to lose at least one game, and obviously Rovers to win three games, and those three games are tough, particularly two of them, Preston away and Bournemouth at home. So for me, it's done, and I just can't help but feel disappointed with how everything's gone today. You've probably got the sense of that with how this match day experience video's gone. You know, not much content I've recorded today. There wasn't much to shout about, not much to get excited about. The first half was just utterly dreadful, and for a side that is chasing the top six, for a side that, you know, is meant to be banging down the door and going back into those playoffs and into that top six, for a side that was given the opportunity to do that by Middlesbrough losing at home to Huddersfield, the way we set up in this game, you know, the back five again, just utterly disappointed with that. And I'm really annoyed with the comments of the manager after the game. You know, a couple of things that he said. The first is, you know, he blamed a lack of atmosphere in the first half and the fans not getting behind the players. Well, for a side that is playing as poorly as we have over the last 15 games, you know, the worst possible thing to do is go behind in the first 4 minutes, which is what we did. So you're instantly not going to have the fans on board there, and we need the players to respond and give us something to shout about. And, you know, that didn't happen. And then, you know, the second thing that I'm really annoyed about is, you know, the fact that there was no response, you know, in that first half to what he was seeing in front of him. You know, I've said it at half time of this video and on the instant reaction video that I did. You know, it was very early and evident, very evident early on in that game that Joe Allen had the freedom of Ewood Park and that the formation was wrong. You know, we were outnumbered in the centre of midfield. Stoke were able to pop it around and be very comfortable either playing the ball out from the back or into Joe Allen to start the moves. And Tony Mowbray should have responded to that sooner. You know, he should have got, you know, be bold and make the substitution, bring someone on. Even if it is 20, 25 minutes, we could see how that game's going. That's the thing that annoyed me. And then to come out after the game and say, maybe I've been too loyal to the players and the system. Yes, Tony, you know, this is the thing that as fans, we've been saying that for weeks, that we need a formation change or something different. You know, the back five has served its purpose when we was on that brilliant run in November and December and keeping it tight and keeping clean sheets. Served a purpose when we was away at Luton and, you know, really fighting to the end of that game with Daniel Ayala up top. You know, it serves a purpose in certain games, but the system needed changing a few weeks ago. You know, maybe after the international break with Ben Brereton coming back at Coventry, I don't know, maybe that was the time to do it, you know, but it served its purpose and we've just lost a huge opportunity now. And yeah, the second half was a better performance. Big shout out to Sam Gallagher, who came out a completely different player and deserved sponsors man of the match for me. I thought he was looking really good in that second half, and if we were going to do something, it was going to be from him. Thought the three substitutions also made an impact. You know, shock horror, John Buckley playing in a midfield three rather than in that false nine position. John Buckley affecting the game in the way that we know he can, and Joe Rothwell coming on as well and making things happen. And we spoke early on in this season about Travis Rothwell and Buckley as that midfield three, and a lot of our success coming from those three as a midfield three. You know, it looked much better in the second half when we had that midfield three restored in the way that it was early on in the season. But too little, too late. And now the calls for the manager have all restarted. And I think, you know, we just need to remind Rovers fans just to go about this in the right way. You know, I'm really angry. I'm really annoyed. It feels like a massive opportunity that we've thrown away. But there is a way that we conduct ourselves from here now, because, you know, this isn't Steve Keane. This isn't Owen Coyle. I'm absolutely convinced that Tony Mowbray wants what's best for the club. It would have been great for Tony Mowbray to get us into that top six, but ultimately we've come up short. So, you know, his contract is up for expiry at the end of the season. It should just be one of those things now that, you know, it's thanks, Tony, you know, and shake his hand and that's it. I think there's just a way that we conduct ourselves from here without it being too toxic. But yeah, my mind's made up, and I think a lot of Rovers fans' minds are made up now. And
you know, it's going to hurt, particularly if we see Millwall make the top six. Luton are looking good in there as well. It will feel like a huge opportunity missed in this season. And, you know, it wasn't a massive run of form that we needed, was it? You know, with the position that we'd got ourselves in January, we just needed that steady run of form. And that's the thing that's going to hurt the most. You know, the form we are in now, the last 15 games, we are bottom of the Championship form table for the last 15 games. The run of form we are on is absolutely dreadful. So, you know, we can talk about no one expected us to be here. We can talk about overachievement. I'm just not buying any of that stuff. You know, this will be a failure if we don't make the playoffs. You know, even if we had six extra points, we'd be sat comfortably within the top six at the moment, and six extra points would have us just mid-table in the Championship form table for the last 15 games. So, you know, that's ultimately the thing that's going to hurt. But yeah, desperately disappointing day. It felt desperate towards the end. It didn't really feel like we were banging down the door there with Stoke. It didn't feel like the crowd was sucking the ball into the net. Sam Gallagher's hit the crossbar. Ryan Hedges has had a header, which was a great save from the keeper. And then there was another Sam Gallagher header that Bonham's tipped over the bar as well. So a few chances where we could have equalised and maybe gone on to get another goal, but ultimately too little too late in that regard. And, you know, for a trio of games that I spoke about, Blackpool, Peterborough and Stoke, I said we needed 9 points ideally. Actually, with the results that, you know, have gone in our favour, we might not have needed 9 points. We probably could have got away with 6 points or even 5 points. But to get 1 point from the last three games, added on to the other opportunities that we've missed as well, you know, Coventry's late equaliser a few weeks ago, losing away at Reading, losing at home to Bristol City, you know, just add on to all of the numerous missed opportunities. And if we do end up falling short by 1, 2, 3, 4 points, whatever it is, you know, we've only got ourselves to blame in that regard. And, you know, that's the thing that's going to hurt the most, I think, that it might be a fairly small points gap, particularly with some of the other sides who are stuttering. So, yeah, apologies that this match day experience probably wasn't the best or most enjoyable. It was one of them where wasn't the day for recording a lot of in-game match content. You know, there wasn't too much of an atmosphere. There wasn't too much to shout about. There wasn't too much to kind of bring you all in terms of match day experience in that regard. So, three games to go, Preston away. Thankfully, with Sheffield United drawing, it means that Preston won't mathematically end it for us if we were to lose at Deepdale. That's what I was fearing. But, you know, make no mistake now, for Rovers to have any chance whatsoever, it's three wins from the next three games, which for me feel just completely unlikely with the run of form we're in. And we're relying on those favours as well. But, yeah, sorry it wasn't the result we needed, Rovers fans. I was hoping that, you know, we'd be sat in the top six after that favour from Middlesbrough today. Not to be. Not to be today. Not to be on the season, most likely. But, you know, the next match day experience that we do is going to be a brilliant one. We've got the Ewood Express going to Ewood Park, and Rovers Chat have done their bit to sponsor that. So I'm really looking forward to at least seeing lots of happy faces from the Asian communities in Blackburn. It's going to be great to see the kids going to the game. So we'll do a bit of match day experience with some footage on the coach and stuff like that. So something to smile about, at least if the playoffs are gone by that point that we play Bournemouth at home. But Preston up next, then Bournemouth, then Birmingham, and then let's see where we finish for the season. Thank you all for the continued support to the channel. Sorry that this one is a depressive match day experience. Not much to shout about today, but please give the video a like. Please subscribe to the channel and we will see you soon. Come on, you Blues.
The Rovers Chat YouTube channel is proudly sponsored by SixYardsOut.com. They've got retro football from every era with mugs, phone cases and much more. They also have plenty of Rovers goods, including apparel with the famous 94-95 season and this season's kit. Check them out using the link in the description below.